Large machine guns have always been fun in Helldivers 2, but none are more fun than the big daddy of them all, the MG206 heavy machine gun. Back to another episode of Deep Dive, where we go in deep on everything Helldivers 2. So the heavy machine gun has come on quite a journey since its release back with the Quasar Cannon so long ago. It's always been kind of that weird, rotten stepchild in the machine gun category because it was extremely clunky to use, and also the fact it had low ergonomics, a lower damage in some cases. It just didn't feel very good and was more annoying to use than anything. But through some various patches that we've gotten to its damage, its reload speed, and also we got an addition of a new piece of equipment that has made this better, and some existing equipment that also makes this better, you can actually use this thing borderline as a primary weapon at times, which is absolutely fantastic. So how did we get here, and why is this thing suddenly more viable than ever to use in Helldivers 2? Let's go over everything you need to know about the heavy machine gun. The tooltip reads, a very powerful but difficult to wield machine gun with intense recoil. So the stat breakdown for the MG206 heavy machine gun is the call-in timer is 7 seconds or 4 seconds with the ship upgrade. The cooldown is 480 seconds or 432 seconds with the first ship upgrade and 410 seconds with the second ship upgrade. The uses are unlimited, so you can use this as many times as you want in a dive. The damage is 150. The ammo capacity is 75 rounds. The backup magazines are 2 mags. The reload time is 5.5 seconds or 4.95 seconds with the ship upgrade. The RPM options are 450 or 600 or 750 rounds per minute. And the armor pen is medium armor penetration. So the ship upgrades that affect the heavy machine gun are donation access license, support weapons deploy with maximum number of carryable magazines. So without this upgrade, you only have one out of your 2 backup magazines available to you. But with this upgrade, you obviously get the full amount, which is 2 out of 2 backup magazines. The next one is streamline request process, which decreases support weapon stratagem cooldown by 10%. So this basically just drops your cooldown from 480 seconds to 432 seconds, so basically 8 minutes to 7 minutes and 10 seconds. Payroll management system reduces reload time for all support stratagems by 10%, so this takes the reload of the heavy machine gun from 5.5 seconds to 4.95 seconds, which I believe the game rounds it up to exactly 5 seconds. Morale augmentation, which reduces cooldown time for all stratagems by 5%, so this further reduces the cooldown of the heavy machine gun from 432 seconds to 410 seconds or 7 minutes and 10 seconds to 6 minutes and 50 seconds roughly. For streamlined launch process, all support weapon stratagems launch immediately once called in, reducing the overall deployment time. Now there is some confusion around this upgrade, and I understand it's not saying that you're literally going to get these weapons immediately or instantly in front of you. That's just not how it works. So in the tooltips, you'll notice that there is a thing that says call-in timer for 3 seconds. This does not mean the stratagem comes in 3 seconds. What this means is that this adds on to your stratagem's call-in. So organically, the heavy machine gun has a 4-second call-in, and then with this 3-second delay timer, that makes it 7 full seconds. So what this ship upgrade does is it removes that delay timer altogether, so now it's a 0-second delay timer, and now it only takes 4 seconds for your heavy machine gun to come in. Now, unfortunately, the complex stratagem modifier, which increases call-in time by 50% on some of your missions, still is taken into consideration, so it's gonna increase the amount of time for your weapons to come in, but just wanted to clarify that because I know there's a lot of confusion around this ship upgrade. So jumping into the general overview for the heavy machine gun, this thing literally is in the name. It's a heavy machine gun, so it is going to be clunkier to use, and it is going to hit a lot harder than the other machine guns in the game. And pair that with the medium arm penetration this thing has, you're going to be doing a lot of damage to the majority of enemies within the game. This weapon also has a high stagger, which works in your favor because you're going to be staggering up some of those Devastator units or any of those other medium units in the game while you're killing them. So according to Helldivers Wiki, this weapon has medium arm penetration level 2, which allows you to penetrate up to gunship bodies, Hulk Eye and Arms, Factory Shredder Eyes, Spore Spewers, and Shrieker Nest. So like I read in the tooltip, one thing to keep in mind is that this magazine is 75 rounds, so it does limit your spray and pay potential, and the reload time is a little bit cumbersome because it requires you to take a knee to reload this thing, so you're not going to be moving while reloading this weapon. But the fact that the reload is really only 5 seconds when you get the ship upgrade makes it pretty quick to reload overall. Now, as I read in the tooltip, we do get multiple RPMs with this weapon, and those are 450, 600, and 750. 600 really feels like the sweet spot for this weapon because 450 just feels way too slow, and then 750 feels like you're expending more ammo than you need to at times, especially if you're trying to tap fire with this thing, so I would stick with 600. So organically, this weapon does have pretty low ergonomics overall. You're not going to be snapping onto targets, you're not going to be quickly turning and spraying enemies with this thing. However, there are some ways you can dramatically improve this, and we're going to jump into that in just a moment. So jumping into the gameplay and overall playstyle of the heavy machine gun, the biggest piece of advice I can give you is that tap firing is your best friend. Not only does this help you maximize that very small clip, but you also will find a huge boost in your overall recoil control capabilities when you're tap firing this weapon. There are two different armor passives that radically impact the performance of this weapon. The first being is the Fortified or Engineer passive, because both of these have the same identical part of their passive, which gives you a 30% reduced recoil while crouched, which you will be doing a lot with this weapon. So if you love to spray and pray with the heavy machine gun, this is going to be able to allow you to do that a lot more accurately, because that 30% is a massive boost to its overall recoil control. The second and by far the best option is the armor passive Peak Physique, which improves your weapon handling with less drag on your weapon movement. And essentially, this dramatically increases the overall ergonomics of your heavy machine gun. With this, you'll be able to not only just snap back and forth very, very quickly, but you'll also be able to walk while using this weapon much more effectively. So if you don't always want to crouch and you want to be moving, you can do that a lot easier with this armor passive. So that's why I said at the beginning of the video that you can use this thing as a primary weapon, because with this armor passive, no longer will you be suffering from these slow, clunky movements. You can actually use this like you're using your normal primary weapons. Another way to greatly improve this weapon's overall performance and dramatically increase its overall uptime is by using the B1 supply pack. So as I said before, you'll only be getting 2 backup magazines with this weapon, and you'll be blowing through those extremely quickly. So with the supply pack, what you'll be getting is you'll be getting 4 little mini resupply packs on your back, which you can use at any time, but for the sake of argument, let's just say you use both your backup magazines. You pop this and you'll get both those backup magazines back, which is absolutely huge. So overall, this supply pack just allows you to use this weapon so much more, so that way you're not just limiting it to just dealing with a few enemies. You can literally be using this on any enemy that comes in front of you. There is one offensive stratagem that will dramatically increase the performance of this heavy machine gun, and that is the Eagle Rocket Pods. So the Eagle Rocket Pods on their own are very powerful. They can one-shot many things in the game. However, their ability on the Terminate side, more specifically, to open up weak spots on Bio Titans and Chargers is invaluable, because what you can do is you can use the rocket pods, blow open the side or the back of a Bio Titan or a Charger, and use your heavy machine gun to hit that weak spot and finish them off very, very quickly. So against the Automaton Elites, this weapon is fairly limited on what it can do directly, but just taking Hulks as an example, you can kill it fairly quickly if you actually attack it by hitting it in the eyeball. But again, this is easier said than done, because when these things are shooting at you, you can sometimes have a difficult time hitting them in the face. Not for Hulks, and then all the automatons with the very large vents on their backside, you can absolutely massacre these very quickly with this heavy machine gun. Again, just like I said previously, make sure that you keep in mind that you can take out gunships with this. So if you're going in to take out one of the gunship factories, feel free to shoot these things out of the sky, because this thing is actually extremely effective against those. Last thing I want to say is that this heavy machine gun is mostly useless against the factory striders. I know they said something about it being effective against this eyeball, but again, it's very unlikely that you're going to hit it consistently there. So just save your ammo and use other things to kill the factory striders. So against the Terminus, probably save the ammo against the smaller bugs if you're just fighting those. But if you have a bunch of medium armored units mixed in there with like the spewers, the brute commanders, the hive guards, the stalkers, or anything like that, feel free to unload this thing onto them, because it's just going to absolutely destroy them very quickly. Also, just keep in mind that you can take out Spore Towers and Shrieker Nest in about a half magazine or so, a little bit more than that. So you can do that. There are more effective ways to do it, but again, you can do it. So against Chargers, outside of the rocket pod thing, like I mentioned before, you can shoot them in the backside and it will do a lot of damage to that area. You can sneaky shoot this thing through their back leg if you want to shoot them from the front. But for the most part, you want them facing away from you when you do this. So for Bile Titans, you're mostly not going to do a lot of damage to them unless you do that rocket pod strategy I mentioned before, but you can shoot the little sack underneath and actually take that out so it stops spitting at your teammates. So what are the overall negatives when using this weapon? On its own, without using any of the mentioned ways I talked about before to improve it, this thing is honestly extremely mediocre. Its ergonomics are overall just very difficult to manage, and the lack of backup ammo you get with this thing really hinders you from using it, and its overall liability with dealing with elite enemies on its own. So unfortunately, unlike most of the other support stratagem weapons in the game, you need to really build around this weapon to really make it work for you. You need to run Peak Physique, you need to run Supply Pack, you need to run Eagle Rocket Pods on the bug side more specifically, to really maximize this weapon's potential. So sadly, because you're taking up so many slots trying to make this weapon better, that limits your offensive stratagems you can run in a mission, unfortunately, which may hinder you against some of the elite enemies if you pick incorrectly. And also why the reload is way better on this weapon, and it has a lot more uptime than it used to because of that reload change, the magazine still feels way too small. Boosting this magazine up to 100, for example, would probably be the sweet spot for this thing because it just needs that little bit of extra ammo to make it just a little bit more viable, in my opinion. So basically, in summary, if you want to run this weapon, you need to build around it. You can't just run it for the heck of it because it's not going to be very useful to you unless you actually build around it with the correct support stratagems and with the correct offensive stratagems, because it's going to be a really big liability when you get into a mission and there's a lot of elites on the map. So what's my final thoughts on my overall ranking for the MG206 heavy machine gun? So overall, for its effectiveness and performance, so with Peak Physique and the supply pack, this weapon is actually extremely effective because you can use it just like a primary weapon, which is really amazing in my opinion. Without them, however, it's usable, but again, the performance takes such a big hit that it's almost not worth bringing this thing over many other support weapon stratagems in the game. However you decide to run this thing though, it does deal a ton of damage to the majority of enemies in the game and does have a lot of versatility so that way you don't always feel like you need to run the same old boring things over and over again. So for the fun factor, this thing is super freaking fun to use and offers a very unique playstyle compared to a lot of other things in Helldivers 2, because again, I've said it many times, this thing can become like a primary weapon for you. I've done kooky builds such as I've run the heavy machine gun as my main weapon, had the crossbow as a way to close up bug holes, for example, and then run like a different secondary or whatever, but it's just been fun being able to like vary up my playstyle and not feel like I'm being held back, because I'm able to run things like Peak Physique and the supply pack to make this thing just keep going for me. So again, it's just a really fun weapon to use. So for my final overall ranking for the heavy machine gun, I give it a solid A. Yes, it does have its limitations when it's used on its own. However, if you really build around this thing, it is a ton of fun to use and offers a very unique playstyle that you can't get with another weapon in Helldivers 2, which I really love a lot. All right, so that's everything you need to know about the heavy machine gun. What are your thoughts below? Do you actually use this thing? Do you like the heavy machine gun? Are you going to consider using it now based off this video? Let me know down in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.